Well, MobiKwik has set its sights on becoming India's first global fintech brand. The company's CEO told Bloomberg he expects it to become profitable by the second quarter of 2019, but that growth comes first.
We are continuing to see fantastic growth, double-digit percentage growth month over month, both in terms of adoption of users as well as merchants. We already added more than a million merchants since demonetization, and it's accelerating. We are adding 10,000 more mom and pop stores every day through our workforce, and we are adding more than 4 million users every month. So, I mean, it's just accelerating.
You are aiming to become profitable by April of 2018. Are you on track?
Yes, we were before demonetization happened. But I think after demonetization happened, what has happened is it's very clear that the market that we were imagining for digital payments, for financial services, is at least 20 times or 30 times bigger than what we were imagining before demonetization. Because really, people were not using MobiKwik a lot for paying at the street, on the road, for buying grocery or for buying train tickets, etc. So that has opened up a fantastic big opportunity to grow significantly before you become profitable. So we may not get there in April 2018, but certainly we are not looking too far away from, let's say, first or second quarter of 2019.
How's your Series D funding going?
It's going along very well. We have a lot of interest, as expected, both from a set of strategic as well as financial investors. One of the investors who's who's quite close to investing to us is actually one of the largest companies in India. And with their help, we are looking to transform our business from payments into a complete financial services brand. So we want to become India's first consumer fintech brand.
We were expecting an announcement by the end of last month. When can we expect one now?
So it's going to happen. It is in the closing stages, and we should expect an announcement by end of June.
RBI has given a payments bank license to Paytm. It has rejected MobiKwik. Mm-hmm. How does that affect your business?
We are very, very thankful for that. In some sense, today we realize that the solution in India is not to open yet another bank. The consumer wants very simple payment options, simple user experience, and a bundling of financial products and services into the same app, which the current banks are unable to serve. So our approach is not to become another bank. Our approach is to actually partner with the existing banks and financial institutions, work closely with them, give them and their users our solution so that it becomes a win-win.